because I'm a sexual person myself. And there's a couple of things that I need to tell you, because I feel personally that men are losing the art of being men.
A minute going, oh my God. She's going to bash us.
No, I'm not. I'm going to inform you. First of all, I want to tell you that women love you. We love men, but women respond to power. We like it when you're aggressive and masterful and masculine. We like that shit. We love that fucking shit. Don't no woman want no bitch ass, soft ass man. Ain't nobody trying to fuck Alan Alda. We like it when you're aggressive and making decisions. See, some kind of way, between all them magazines and glorious signs, men have lost their way. Some of y'all walking around when you ain't got your fatigues on, wearing pink shirts. That's the most faggot shit. Quit it. Don't no real man wear no pink shirt. And if your woman buy you a pink shirt, you have my permission to wear it and beat up with it.
Grandmama gave her. It'll come up to here and she'll put on the drawers
up to here. And some socks. I don't know what the socks are, but we do that. Now, I'm going to tell you how you handle that situation. When you go in the bedroom, she's going to have her back turned to you, and she don't want to see your face. This is what you do. You get in the bed, and you flip her over, and you strap her, and you look her dead in her eyes, and you say, we ain't going to bed bad tonight. And you rip that nightgown off her, you tear the panties off her, you fuck the shit out of her. I bet you have pancakes for breakfast in the morning. Because you don't understand them. Like every time you watching some kind of game, some sports thing on ESPN, here comes your woman. And ladies, don't lie. We all do it, including me. As soon as you see he's into that game, here you come. I need to talk to you. Men, I'm going to tell you something. We really don't have shit to say. It's just that we hate to think that that game is more important than we are. So I'm going to tell you how you handle that situation. You say, come here, baby. Come sit on daddy's lap. We like it when you call yourself daddy. And you lick her neck right about here. Now, when you lick her neck right about here, you slide her down. She gon' suck your dick. After she suck your dick, you give her a credit card. She'll go to the mall and buy some shoes. You see the game in peace. Something for her, something for you. Now, before I go, I want to tell you something from my heart. I never thought I would come to Iraq because a lot of people, agents and managers told me not to come. Okay? You don't know what's over there. Just something can happen to you. Well, shit, I live in L.A. Something can happen to me. But I've known Olivia for a long time, over 20 years. And she's always been a person of her word. And if she said it was going to be all right, because we're both Christians, it's going to be all right, because God said it's going to be all right. So I put my big ass on this plane. I didn't get stuck like this. But I put my ass on the plane. And I am grateful to God that I got to meet you. And I talked to a lot of soldiers, and I've heard stories, and if God let me come back, I'll come back. And I want to thank you for having me. But before I leave, I need to tell you ladies something. How many of you ladies, by applause, have a good man? I mean a damn good man. All right then. Every morning before your damn good man go to work, when you get home or if he's here, I want you to suck his dick. And I don't mean that mediocre shit you do when you don't want to be bothered. I mean, I found y'all up in your throat. I'm going to tell you why. Because a man whose dick is sucked well before he goes to work is a man that's hopeful, inspired, rejuvenated. He's even nice to that neighbor he can't stand. Hey, Bob, got the dick sucked. You don't know nothing about that. Not to mention it cuts down on road rage. So, ladies, this is my mantra to you. Suck a dick, save a life. Thank you for letting me be myself, and God bless you all.